Welcome to another video on solving two-step equations. This video will deal with two-step equations with fractions. Remember, when solving a two-step linear equation, the goal is to isolate the variable on one side of the equation. And we'll do this by first adding or subtracting in order to isolate the variable term, and then we'll multiply or divide in order to isolate or solve for the variable. And then step three, we should check our answers. It is important to remember that in order to maintain equality, we must perform the same operation on both sides of the equation. So number one, we have 2x plus 1/4 equals 3/5. The variable is on the left side of the equation, so our ultimate goal is to have x equals some numerical value. So in order to isolate the variable here, we have to undo this 2 and undo this 1/4. We have to ask ourselves, which one can we get rid of by adding or subtracting? Well, the opposite of plus 1/4 is minus 1/4. So we're going to have to subtract 1/4 on both sides of the equation to start with. So we'll subtract 1/4 here and subtract 1/4 here. Plus 1/4 minus 1/4, that's 0. So we have 2x on the left equals, now here we're going to have to get a common denominator. That's going to be 20, so multiply this by 4 over 4, that'll give us 20. Multiply this by 5 over 5, that'll give us 20 in the denominator. So we're going to have 12/20 minus 5/20. So we're going to have 2x equals, this will be 7/20. And here we have to be a little bit careful. This is attached by multiplication, so the opposite of multiplying by 2 would be dividing by 2. The problem is, this is in fraction form over here. So instead of dividing by 2, it might be helpful if we multiply by the reciprocal. So dividing by 2 over 1 is the same as multiplying by 1 over 2. Notice when we do this, this is lined up nicely on the right side. And on the left side, this simplifies nicely as well. This 2 simplifies out, so we have 1x, or just x. And on the right side, nothing really simplifies here, so we can multiply across the top. That'll be 7 over 20 times 2, so 7 over 40 would be our solution. Let's go ahead and try another one. Here we have 2/5 x minus 1/2 equals 3/5. Again, the variable is on the right side, so our ultimate goal is to have x equals some numerical value. And we could undo the minus 1/2 if we add 1/2 on both sides. That's going to be our first step. This 2/5 is attached by multiplication, so we'll have to undo that in the second step. So again, to undo the minus 1/2, we'll add 1/2 on both sides. So this would be 0, that's why we did that. So we have 2/5 x equals, here we have to have a common denominator, so that's going to be 10, multiply this by 2 over 2, multiply this by 5 over 5. Notice both denominators are now 10. We're going to have 6/10 plus 5/10. So let's go ahead and write this again. We have 2/5 x equals 11/10. This 2/5 is attached by multiplication, but again, instead of dividing by 2/5, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal, so multiply both sides by 5/2. The left side simplifies perfectly. We're left with 1x or x. On the right side, the 5 and the 10 simplify. This would be 1, this would be 2. Looks like we have 11/4. This is perfectly fine for an answer and is correct, but it is an improper fraction. We could convert this to a mixed number by taking 11 and dividing by 4. There are 2 4s in 11, that would be 8 with a remainder of 3. That tells us 11/4 is equivalent to 2 3/4. Either answer is correct, and in simplest form, just one's improper and one's a mixed number. Number three, we have 1/4 equals 3/5 x minus 5. Now our variable is on the right side, So that means when we get done, we're going to have some number equals x on the right. So looking at the right side, which can we undo by adding or subtracting? Well, we could undo minus 5 by performing the opposite operation or adding 5. So we'll add 5 to both sides of the equation. So we'll add 5 on the right, and we'll add 5 on the left. But when I put plus 5 on the left, I'm going to put plus 5 over 1 because I am going to have to get a common denominator here. So the common denominator here is going to be 4, so I'll multiply this by 4 over 4. So on the left, we're going to have 1/4 plus 20/4 equals, we'll have 3/5 x, and then minus 5 plus 5, that's 0. That's why we did that. Let's go ahead and write this again. Notice I am showing quite a few steps, but if it helps me get the correct answer, I'd rather show more steps than less. So to isolate x, we have 3/5 times x. So we could divide by 3/5, but instead we'll multiply by the reciprocal, or multiply by 5/3 on both sides. Let's take a look at the left side. This simplifies here. There's 1/3 and 3 and 7/3 and 21. That looks like that's about it. So on the left we have 35/4. And on the right, again, these are reciprocals. So 5 over 5 and 3 over 3. That would all be 1x or just x. This is our solution. And again, it is an improper fraction. Let's go ahead and practice converting it to a mixed number. 35 divided by 4, that's going to go in 8 times the remainder of 3. This is equivalent to 8 3/4. We have one more problem here. Notice this is a mixed number. Let's go ahead and convert this to an improper fraction. 5 times 2 plus 1, that's going to be 11/5 equals, here we have 2/3 minus 1/2 x. This 1/2 is attached by multiplication, so we need to undo or get rid of this 2/3 first. It's a positive 2/3, so we're going to have to subtract 2/3 on both sides. So we have 2/3, and then we'll subtract 2/3, and then we have the original minus 1/2 x. We still have to subtract 2/3 on the left side. Let's see what we have. To perform this, we'll have to have a common denominator that'll be 15, so multiply this by 3 over 3, multiply this by 5 over 5. Let's show one more step here. We have 33/15 minus, this will be 10/15 equals 2/3 minus 2/3. That's a 0, that's why we did that. And we're left with minus 1/2 x or a negative 1/2 x. Let's go ahead and simplify the left side. 33/15 minus 10/15 will be 23/15 equals negative 1/2 x. It's attached by multiplication, but again, instead of dividing by negative 1/2, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal, or negative 2 over 1. Simplify. Here nothing really simplifies, so we're going to have negative 43/15 equals, the right side simplifies perfectly. We have negative 2 over negative 2, 1 over 1. So this will be 1x or just x. And again, this is an improper fraction. It is simplified. Let's go ahead and convert it to a mixed number. We know this is going to be a negative value, so I'll put the negative there. Then we'll take 43 and divide by 15. Let's go ahead and do it up here. This is going to go 2 times. 2 times 15 is 30. We subtract, that'll be 13. This is equivalent to 2 13/15. Remember that it was negative. Okay, that'll do it for this video. I hope you found these examples helpful.